Now, name all the members of the monstrous regiment of women.
Beryl.
Linda.
Jean.
Shirley.
Angry Sue.
She's the leader.
Have you heard of the monstrous regiment of women? The first blast of the trumpet against the monstrous...
John Knox?
Yes, John Knox. I knew you would. The first blast of the trumpet against the monstrous...
Monstrous regiment of women. Monstrous. OK, so I've read that, and it's bad that I couldn't remember the monstrous regiment. It seems like it's kind of the main part. Do you... It seems like...
Oh. Actually, what it is a slight change in the language, and monstrous doesn't mean monstrous, as we would say. It means unnatural.
Mm.
And regiment doesn't mean the whole load of them marching on, these women. It means regime.
Right.
And he was a Protestant. And he was angry at the fact there were two Catholic women on the thrones of England.
Course.
Who might they have been?
Mary.
Which Mary? They were both called Mary.
Two Marys.
The two Marys.
Exactly. This has now turned into a story from the Bunty.
There was our Mary, Bloody Mary. Bloody Mary, Mary Tudor, the one who burned the Protestants. Mm. And in Scotland, it wasn't Mary Queen of Scots, it was her regent, who was Mary of Guise.
Cheery bunch.
Yeah, cheery.
I feel like that's the same Mary in different outfits.
Yeah. You know, when they do like those style challenges on This Morning and it's before and after.
She used to just wear monochrome, but look at her now.
So Knox, who was a very keen Protestant, didn't like these women on the throne. He was angry about it and wrote this thing. But on the subject of Mary Queen of Scots, do you remember who her husband was? Darnley, his name was, her husband. He was murdered. He was actually blown up. This is a very extraordinary story. One of the presumed architects of the explosion was a fellow called Archibald Douglas. A pair of his shoes were found at the scene of the crime. He gave an account of...
Where's your shoes, Archibald?
You've got to take your shoes off before dynamite.
Yeah, he got away with it. But he later gave an account of Mary's reaction. So this is Mary. Her husband has been blown up.
Mm.
She sent for a number of light ladies and women to come to Holyrood House and participate stark naked in a ball. Then they had cut off their pubic hair and had put it in puddings to be eaten by the male guests who were sick.
Is that what you do when your husband's blown up? Was she just trying to, you know, like, trying to get back to normal life? Bruce, let's just carry on as we were.
That's right.
Get your pubes and put them in that pie.
It's what he would have wanted.
Actually, I think this would be quite clever. Probably, if your partner is killed in a horrific way, all anyone's ever going to talk to you about is, oh, what happened to your husband? But now, no.
Yeah.
Why do you have that pube party? Why was it in jail?
It's all the detail we have.
One, condolences. Number two.
It's all the detail we have, sadly. But the actual person who took the rap for the murder, it was hanged, drawn and quartered on the basis that he was the one who discovered the scene, which seems a bit unfair.
Oh, really?
His name was William Blackadder.
Oh.
It's true.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Please, come on, pick something.